The current exposure limit in BC is 0.1 fibers per mil. Now, a mil is a cubic centimeter, so it's about that big. And it's a tenth of a fiber, tenth of an asbestos fiber in there. It is a very, very low exposure limit. As far as regulations are concerned, in most places in the world, the concentration of asbestos in a product so that it's considered an asbestos-containing product and all the regulations apply is anywhere between 0.1% and 1%. Research has been done that shows that if you don't take precautions, even if you have a fraction of a percentage, like a tenth of a percent of asbestos in vermiculite, that can turn into 100 times the exposure limit for workers who are working around it. They have a term in the industry called friable that you also see in the regulation, which means it can be crumbled in the hand. And if you're playing with that sort of stuff, your risk level is going to be a lot higher. It's amazing how loose this stuff is and how the asbestos can get out into the air and get distributed. In terms of asbestos, it's not just the percentage that you're looking at. You're looking at how much are you going to be disturbing and how are you going to be disturbing it. You got a couple of guys running around going after drywall with crowbars and absolutely no precautions. I've seen it. They're just covered with white stuff. And that can lead to some real severe consequences for people. This is something that has to stop. We need to carry on pushing the asbestos button as hard as we can because we can. We can do it and we can prevent these things from happening. We can prevent these diseases.